Hi, my name is Lauren Wade. I've been a drama major for 5 years, and I'm here with Mr. Bryson.
Hi, Lauren.
Hi.
Nice to have you here.
Thanks. Glad to be here. So you've taught musical theater at this school for a number of years. What is your background in musical theater?
I got my first job back at Sands in 1982, and the woman that was putting on the musical was our teacher, and she needed to kind of started falling apart, and so I helped her put it on, and then she left the next year, and all of a sudden I was a drama teacher. So okay, so I had a huge choir program and a huge drama program overnight. So and yeah, just and then so I just started music. I did 7 musicals while I was there, and yeah, it was fun. It was fun. We had a great time.
What persuaded you to start Project Kenya?
Persuaded me to start. I don't think I started Project Kenya. We started Project Kenya. And it was just, I mean, for years actually at the school, I wanted to get some international and some global citizenship thing going, and nobody, everybody was kind of yes and yes, and I tried a few administrators, nobody's really kind of keen on it, and then it kind of faded away. And then Jillian Player just right in front of us from Kenya, and she had this school that she'd been working on, and she had the connections with the Conservancy, and Jim knew her, and she brought her over, she spoke to the kids, it was crazy, said, I'm on, and Sylvia jumped on, Penny jumped on, Don and everybody just jumped into the project. It was just, it wasn't me starting, it was a synergy by a bunch of people at the school that said, this is awesome, let's do something really cool, and we did.
Can you explain in your own words why you think advocating for the environment is important?
What? Why do I have to say that? Doesn't everybody know? Do you want me to get started? I'll tell you why. We're in a planetary crisis, and everybody's twiddling their thumbs, and it makes me mad. Mad in the sense of going insane in both and angry. We have to keep the fossil fuels in the ground. That's over. That has to stop yesterday. And governments are not going to do it. I think it's going to take a huge amount of civil disobedience to stop the people in power from doing what they do, because they're so ingrained in the old paradigm. And that is the problem. It is a huge problem. The other problem is that the financialization of the economy that's happened over the last 30 years has increased that. So now we have this horrible trifecta of the environment, the financialization, and taking over the mass media by like 6 companies in the United States that are, we've gotten very narrow, narrow, narrow. And everybody's just watching the Kardashians. So I'm hoping, and I'm desperately hoping that people are going to start waking up and start marching in the streets, because I think only massive civil disobedience is going to be the thing that gets people going. We have to design a circular economy. So what we take from the planet goes back into the planet. We have to find a way of doing that, and quickly.
What is your favorite production that you've directed, and why?
Favorite production? I mean, Macbeth was wonderful. It was fantastic, because I had so many wonderful male actors that year. Both Bertella shows were magical in their own different ways. Noises Off was fantastic, because my daughter was in it. And working with Lucas Blaney, who's now at Sing, doing really well, was really awesome. Our Town was fantastic. I loved it because I love the message of Our Town. It's wonderful. And, you know, Reflections on Crooked Walking, which I did, back in 97. It was a great show. There's been lots. I can't even remember them all, but great. And the pressure of performance, you know what I'm talking about. You're all drama majors. Getting all together and having something shiny come out at the end is all quite magnificent. Yes.
What do you feel is your greatest accomplishment?
What do I feel is my greatest accomplishment? Giving kids a voice, helping them find their voice. As a drama teacher, you pretty much, if you can't do that, you're kind of lost. So that's what I've done.
Very good. How did you feel after your farewell?
It was awesome. Oh my God, I felt so honored. I just about lost it with the First Nations kids dancing and singing. It was really cool. It was really, really cool. Jessica Slater, thank you for that, by the way, Jessica. That was really lovely. And, you know, Ilya's song and all that stuff. It was magnificent. I felt truly honored. I couldn't have asked any more. You know, whole bunch of other kids came to the pub afterwards, kids I hadn't seen in 15, 20 years, and it was magnificent. Like, lots of beautiful cards and letters, and yeah, it was quite over the top, to tell you the truth.
What is your favorite thing about high school students, and what is your least favorite thing about high school students?
Well, they're so stupid. They're stupid in a beautiful teenage way, because they're awkward, they're insecure as hell. But there's this little glistening things that they come up with, and they're like bumbling puppies falling over themselves, and it's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. But it's really fun watching them grow up, like in grade 11, 12, and you actually start having kind of adult conversations. It's quite magnificent. But yeah, basically, it's because they're just small embryos of adults. I hate to break it to you guys, but we're not that much better. We just lie better. We're better liars. We're probably just as insecure as every damn teenager that's up there. But I digress. I love them. But everybody grows up. I'm always amazed. You can't ever make a decision about a kid at any age because you have no idea where they're going to go. And we can make all kinds of overreaching statements about kids, but we don't know. I can say, oh, that kid's got great this, great. You don't know. By the time they're in grade 12, they're amazing. I had this kid in my first, when I taught musical theater in Sands, Chris Vonsbeck, and he used to come up for all my chorus and stuff. You know, typical teenagers full of pimples and please don't look at me, loved to sing. He went off to RADA, Royal Academy of Dramatic Arts, in England, he did brilliantly over there. He's still over there. Who am I to know, you know?
What are your plans for next year?
None of your business.
Oh.
No.
All right.
Just kidding.
Never mind.
What are my plans for next year? Well, my wife and I are going to taking our daughter, Jessica, to Greece for a couple of weeks. And then she's flying back. And then we're going to Turkey for a couple more weeks. Hope to get involved in some demonstrations there. Should be a lot of fun. I think I'll be the standing. You heard about the standing man over there?
Oh, yeah.
Is that cool or what?
Yeah.
So they just, you know, just one guy just stands there, just, you know, stands against a building or at a building, and then people just start joining, don't say a word, stand there for 3 hours. Please come, you walk away. So, yeah, I think I might do that. Sounds like fun.
What advice do you have for new teachers?
Look. Like I said before, look into their eyes and see all those hopes and insecurities and love them for it because it's boiling out of their pores. Forgive them because you'll need lots of patience. And find the laughter because they love to laugh and they love to find the laughter. Find the laughter and find the love. If you get those two things going, you'll be fine.
What do you want to be remembered for?
Besides my good looks?
What? No,
is that funny?
It's not funny. I'm agreeing.
Oh, well, I hope for helping getting Project Kenya off the ground. I hope I'm remembered for that. I think it will be. And I think that was demonstrated at my farewell and at the bar afterwards that when you give out love, you get it back. And everybody needs a little kindness, a little wink, a little encouragement, no matter what age you are. And life can be pretty good. I have no regrets about teaching at all. It was a wonderful career for me. Perfect fit. And I'm glad to still be young enough so I can go and do some other things.
What was your dream profession when you were younger?
Oh, I was trying to impress my girlfriend. I was going to be a professional soccer player. That didn't work out. I don't know. I was hoping to be a professional musician, but that didn't work out. I wasn't good enough. That would probably be it, you know, just because I love music. But I don't know, I have lots of fantasies, but I'm not going to share those with you, what I think I could have been. Because they're kind of silly fantasies that everybody goes through in your 20s and 30s and 40s and 50s. Now my 60s. I don't know. I just followed whatever kind of fell in front of me. And went in and out of school for a long period of time until I ended up being a teacher. And waiting for a long time was a good idea for me because finally at the age of 32 I became a teacher and it was good. It was a great thing to do. Yeah.
Thank you very much. I have just one last...
That's it?
Yeah, one more question.
You haven't reached the depth of my soul
no,
yet.
No, I'm about to.
Oh, God.
Who's your favorite drama student?
Oh, what's the matter with you? You don't got no problems? You look at me, you laugh, you say your name is Lawrence of Arabia. I don't get it at all. My mother, she used to throw stones at me when I was a small boy and keep me from attacking the goats. It wasn't my fault. She looked angry. It's their eyes. It's their eyes. It's their eyes that they look at you and they say, I'm going to butt you with my head because I'm an angry goat. An angry, angry goat. Yeah. Or sometimes it can be my friend Lobo. He comes from, I'm not too sure where, it's in the Midlands, I think. He's got very bad teeth there. And he talks ever so pristinely. Hello, darling. Lovely. Can I touch that vase?
Water.
I want some water. Some water, Mr. Bryson, because I'm full of marshmallows. On the yellow brick road, on the fine, 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 the yellow brick road, we're up to see the mosaic, and we're going to go. Somebody stop me, I can't know. I reached the bottom, the pit of doom, the pit of doom, I tell you.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Lauren.
Thank you for your time.
My pleasure. Ashley, nice talking to you. Oprah and
up. Thumbs up. Yeah.